Taylor Tomlinson. Tomlinson? Quarter life crisis. Let's get it. Okay, fresh off of work, and Taylor Tomlinson just dropped her first comedy special on Netflix, and you know me, man, this is what I do. Okay, this is what I like to do. Rephrase that. Okay, anyway, the first time I ever heard of Taylor Tomlinson was on the Burt Kreischer podcast, and I had second thoughts about her coming off of it because she was young, and they spoke on that a lot about how she's younger and she's doing her recording her first hour special for Netflix, her first comedy special for Netflix. And I was like, dang, they're just giving these out to anybody who's got jokes. So I was a little skeptical coming into it. It came out, I think, a day or two, like a day ago, and I didn't jump on it right away. But earlier today, I had a little bit of free time, and I thought, well, let's just give it a shot. You know, I'm a fan of comedy. I'll give anybody 10, 15 minutes. If you can't catch, you know, you can't catch me with anything, you can't pique my interest, you know, it's on to the next one. And so I put it on, and I will say that it was a lot better than I expected. She is very fucking talented and very fucking funny. She has a lot of potential. With only being 25 and being this goddamn funny, like, the sky's the fucking limit. You know what I mean? I'm not gonna say any of the greats female comics, you know what I mean? But she has potential of being up there with any of them. I will say that her material was very well put together for being so new to the comedic scene. One thing I noticed is she is a student of comedy, because in her storytelling, when she is breaking down a story, she throws little one-liners in. And these little one-liners are perfectly placed to keep your interest on her story. Now, when you hear Bill Burr, Dave Chappelle, you know, some of these big time storytellers, they don't have to throw in these one-liners because they already have your interest because of their popularity. So when they're telling you a story, you're already engaged, waiting for the punchline, waiting for the end of the story to get the kicker. You know what I mean? You're focused in just because, oh, you're in awe. With her, she doesn't really have that, I would assume, level of popularity. So she puts in these little one-liners to get you to, you know, to tune in to the bigger picture of her story. And then she drops a bomb at the end. I was very fucking impressed with that, because you don't see a lot of comics do that. And if you do, you don't see them doing it effectively. And overall, it is tougher for me to engage and or listen to female comics because of relatability. A lot of the stuff that I hear from female comics, it doesn't go over my head, but I can't be like, oh, yes, you know. But if it's funny, it's funny. And for her, I think she fucking murdered this shit. If you haven't seen it, go check it out. Taylor Tomlinson, Quarter Life Crisis. One of the better ones. I will say, I was anticipating more on the Pete Davidson special, and she blew him out of the water. No offense to Pete, you're my guy, I love you, my dude, but, you know, she fucking murdered it, and you gotta give the flowers when they're due. So, if you've seen it, comment below, like, subscribe, do your goddamn thing. Taylor Tomlinson, props to you, girl. You impressed me, and you know, that's not... for what it's worth. And some random dude in his fucking car after work on YouTube. Anyway, yeah, go check that shit out, man. We out of here.